You know when you hear this beat, it gets real. You know when you hear this beat, it gets real. PlayStation Nation. YouTube. Yo, what's good YouTube? What's up PlayStation Nation? It is your boy, your man, Jay Barry, and I'm back with another video. Giving you greatness once again, which is the PlayStation Nation, which is the PlayStation 4. You know the rigmarole, how what I say, what I do in the beginning of my videos. You know. But yeah, man. I just want to talk about these two articles that I've seen. That popped up in the past couple of days. We kind of missed it on the council podcast. We probably will be talking about it during on Thursday in the council podcast. So we'll see. You know what I mean? It's kind of old. It's probably like Friday, the weekend kind of news. But we're still probably gonna cover it because I think it's very important to cover this news. But before you know we do that, please before I talk about these articles. Check out the Council Podcast. Check out the other videos that I put up there about Street Fighter and all that stuff. And make sure you guys join the PlayStation community at PlayStation Nation All-Stars Facebook group. Don't miss out on that group, guys. But yo, let's get right into it. Sony has no first-party Vita games in development. First-party strategy focus on PS4. Jay Barry, are you mad? Yeah, I'm mad a little bit. Not even gonna lie, because I do feel like the Vita is a great device that a lot of people are sleeping on. And if you have a PS4, the Vita definitely complements it in a great way. You know what I mean? But it is what it is, man. I think with the Vita, they kind of messed up with the whole memory card stuff because they were very expensive. And I understand why they try to do it. When it came to the Vita, because the PSP, you know, everybody was just hacking it and downloading games and all that good stuff, where you can just use it on a regular, you know, mini SD card. Where here now they have something more locked in, where Sony style, and they'd be like, no, you guys can't do this, you guys can't do that, you gotta buy our accessory. You know what I mean? And it is what it is. But with the Vita, I felt like they didn't really have that much first party support, but they did have some type of games on there. And it is kind of sad that Sony's not going to be supporting it. But like I said, and I always will say, when people come to you with that BS talking about sales don't matter, here's a perfect example where sales, when it comes to hardware, matters. You know what I mean? Where people always say, oh, sales don't matter, sales don't matter. But nah, if the Vita sold as expected from Sony, you know, there would be, this article probably wouldn't even exist. You know, the difference between the PSP and the Vita, the PSP had tons of support. You know what I mean? As far as people buying it hardware, you know what I mean? I don't know too much about the software sales. I'm not going to try to predict that. But I know for the hardware, a lot of people bought PSPs. The Vita is like the opposite story. A lot of people buy their games that own a Vita, but a lot of people is not attaching themselves to the actual Vita, you know what I mean, the actual hardware. So yeah, you know what I'm saying, if you don't have those hardware sales, you're going to begin to lose support with these consoles, you know what I'm saying, that we love and stuff like that. You know what I mean? That's why I don't understand when people say sales don't matter, people don't want to talk about this stuff. But yeah, if you don't have the support where people is buying your consoles, you got to drop certain support. You know what I mean? Why would you put all your invested time into that device where people's not supporting? But the silver lining in this article is that first party strategies focus on PS4. So all first party studios is on that PS4. Because guess what, guys? The PS4 has support. People are buying those up. You know what I mean? The games, everything, they're buying that up in droves. But yeah, my thoughts on this, I think it's a little sad. But at the end of the day, I didn't really see too many first party games. But it would be nice to see some first party games in there, because it will boost sales, I guess. But the handheld market is tricky, man. I'm not even gonna try to predict it. It's a little tricky out here in these gaming streets when it comes to handhelds in the US. But yeah, it's a little sad. It's kinda expected. I think I heard something like this like a year ago. But it is what it is, man. You know what I'm saying? Soon is the Vita's not dead. It's just on life support. But yo, let me talk about this other article that I see about Sony saying that they might release a high performance PS4 with more memory, GPU, CPU, and Ultra HD Blu-ray support. So yeah, yo, this thing might be pumping out some 4K Blu-ray support, Ultra HD Blu-ray support. The PS4 doesn't currently support that kind of format, but they're saying that, you know, so this PS4 is under consideration when it comes to those things it will support. Can't talk about specifics content, but thinks performance boost might require a lot of timing when using something better than x86 architecture. So in other words, it's possible. For example, there are ideas such as releasing a standard PS4 and a high performance PS4. Hey yo, my thoughts, if this do happen, I'm all for it. You know what I'm saying? Like I really do think that the hardcore audience is going to be more for this, because what you're not losing anything, you're gaining what everybody wants. You know what I mean? Everybody always talking about, oh, these consoles, you know, can't really do this, these consoles can't really do that. But I see a lot of people, when this article come out, people was getting upset, like, I don't think Sony should do this, this is wrong, this is not for the gamer. Yeah, you've been complaining for 2 years about, hey, where's your 1080p 60 frames per second locked and all that stuff, you know what I mean? So me personally, I really think this is great news. But one thing I do see the negative aspects in this article is that it can fragment the market, and you don't want confusion when it comes to gamers. You know what I mean? Like people saying, oh, which PS4 should I get? Should I get this one? Should I get that one? But it really shouldn't confuse you. It's kind of like the iPhone. You know what I'm saying? You got the iPhone regular and you got the iPhone Plus. You know what I mean? If Sony can do it, I say go for it, man, because I really do think the hardcore people will eat this thing up, you know, because I know I will. I'll buy a new PS4 with better performance ASAP. You know what I mean? Not saying that the PS4 is some slouch, but I will buy that ASAP. You know what I mean? That's no hesitation in my opinion. But yo, let me know what you guys think in the comment section. Do you think this is a waste of time, waste of resources, bringing out a new PS4? Do you think Sony's wrong for this, or do you think Sony has a right idea when it comes to, you know, having two different PS4s on the market, similar to how the iPhone is with the regular iPhone and the iPhone Plus? Nobody's confused with that one, you know what I mean? So let me know in the comment section. Also on the Vita news, you know, is it RIP Vita time? Let me know in the comment section, man. But yo, it's your boy Jay Barry. Enjoy the rest of the gameplay. I think this is coming to an end right here. You know, your boy is just beasting. We pretty much dominated these guys. And this is an old little Black Ops 3 clips. But I say, you know what? Might as well just throw them up there. You know what I'm saying? In case people miss this stuff out. Because when that Black Ops 3 come out, I'm a beast. So you will see a lot of this stuff on my channel. But yo, it's your boy Jay Barry. Let me know in the comment section below how you feel. And I'm gone! Deuces!
Pineapple King. Dang, they got me. He took mad long to kill him.